That's what they say, is they say that a long time ago that our people used to live along the Mississippi River, down there in Missouri, Nebraska. That's where Haudenosaunee people used to live a long time ago. And all through that area there, that's all the prime farmland. And that's, you know, even still today, when they talk about Nebraska, that's the name of their university, the Cornhuskers. And that's where our original territories was down around that area, just off the Mississippi. And what our ancestors, what they used to call the Mississippi River, is we used to call that Yungwasutslago. And that means like our great ancestor, or our great grandma, our great grandfather. That's what we used to call that river, Yungwasutslago. And what happened was, they said that at that time that our population had exploded. And so there wasn't enough resources in that area for, you know, to sustain our people. And so we had to move. And that's when we moved to New York State. And even then, when we migrated, we moved up there as one group. And then as time, you know, progressed and our population grew, we spread out, you know, over the state. And then we broke up into these little different subgroups. And then we had, you know, all these different dialects, you know, showing up, you know, as far as Iroquoian language goes. You know, and that's, you know, that was kind of like the development or the start of Mohawk language, Oneida language, Onondaga language, Cayuga language, and Seneca language. And when we really look at all those languages, the roots, they're all the same. But if you can imagine when English people, when they first moved here from, you know, across the ocean, and they spoke English, you know, if you listen to the English language that's spoke here now in North America, it doesn't sound like the language that come from England. It has a different accent, it has a different dialect, it has different slangs. You know, things that they call, you know, certain things over there, we don't call certain things over here. You know, there's just so much language evolution that has happened, even with the English language, just over a short period of time. And so you can imagine the evolution that would have taken place with our language as our people started to branch out and our population grew. So when we go back to that and we look at a word like corn, and we say, well, what does that word mean? Because our knowledge of this word is recent. You know, 150 years ago, some of our people, they couldn't speak English. You know, they didn't know, you know, they didn't even know what that word was, corn, because they didn't speak English. But this word was floating around. This word was in use. We knew what that was. And so that was kind of like, you know, what the struggle was for us at that time when I was learning, when I was starting to learn as a teenager. When I would ask that, well, what does that word mean? And so Ray John, he was one of the first ones to really, you know, start to take these words apart and say, well, there's a root word in there someplace. And so when we look at this other word, and if we... look at it in terms of this. And we say wagnast. In our language, when we say that, we say wagnast. What that means is it means that I'm stingy of it. Or if you talk about your children and you say wagnast, you know, wagnast in yung waksad, that means you're real protective or stingy of your kids. They're real precious to you. You just want to hold them close to you. You don't want, let nothing happen to them. And that's the word that we talk about when we talk about our children, that we say wagnats. And so we started looking at that relationship here between this nus and the whole nus up here. And we started to really look at that word, and we said, well, you know, no, it doesn't mean corn. You know, so when we translate that word and we start to tell people, you know, well, what does this word mean? We have to look at it from an Iroquoian perspective as to how did we look at corn. And corn was such a huge part of our life because it was one of our main food staples. And when we talk about our food life, we say Junhekwa. Junhekwa. So we say, Junhekwa is what we call our food. So this part right here, this unhe, what that's talking about is it's talking about life. So this jun in the front here, jun, it's talking about us. And we're saying that we, and this part here is we're saying it's used for, or it's an instrument that is used for, something is used for. So we're saying we use it for life. It supports our life. So a lot of times that's what you'll hear people talk about. When they talk about the three sisters, they'll say, refer to them as our life supporters. Because that's what they do. It's in, they're an instrument that we use to give us life. They provide life for us. You know, we eat and we live. You know, we don't eat, we don't live. And it was a very simple idea that our people understood a long time ago. We needed to have food to survive. And that's why, like I said, a long time ago in our ancient homelands in along the Mississippi, that's all we done is we planted corn. We were an agricultural people. You know, and when we moved up here to this territory, it was a different climate, it was a different landscape. And when we moved up here, we had to learn from the Adirondack people and the Algonquins. It was the Algonquins that taught us how to hunt. Because we knew a little bit about hunting, we knew a little bit about fishing, but we had to make a trade with them. And we said, if you guys teach us how to hunt, then we'll teach you how to plant gardens. Because at that time, they were more into foraging and just picking wild plants that grew out there in nature. And they weren't really into cultivating, whereas we were the masters of cultivating. And so that was the trade-off that we made when we moved up into this area. So when we look at that, the way that we looked at this, and we look at how everything is all related, corn is a part of this. It's a part of Junhek. It's what gives us life. And then when we say Wagnas, that means that we're precious of it, or we value it. We're real stingy of it. You know, we're protective of it. And why are we protective of it? Because it provides life to us. And so then that comes back to this word here, Wagnas, what we call our corn. And that's really what it means, is that we're really precious of that gift. Because we say that those three sisters, that they were a gift to our people in the beginning, in the creation story.